By the end of week two, this is where we arrived. We had learned how to block for registers so that a micro tile of C was brought into registers. We had learned to partition the matrices A and B into micro panels, and to then cast our computation in terms of a microkernel that performed rank one updates to that micro tile. And then we had a loop around all of these tiles to compute all of them, so that we ended up with something like I, J, a loop index by, we did a loop index by J, and then a loop index by I, and then here we did a call to the microkernel. That captures this right here. And if you look at the graphs that that created, this actually achieved really good performance when the problem size was small. And what you just learned in the launch of this week was that a modern architecture, a modern CPU, has a hierarchy of memories. And that then should help you understand that the reason why you got very good performance when the problem size was small was because the problems fit in one of the caches, and which cache we're going to find out a little bit later. So as long as this subproblem fit in the cache, or rather as long as the complete problem fit in the cache, we achieved high performance. Now the other thing that we've learned is that if we partition the matrix into blocks, then you can orchestrate your complete matrix-matrix multiply as a sequence of matrix-matrix multiplies with those blocks. So you should then immediately go, aha, and recognize that if we have to do a large matrix-matrix multiply, larger than what fits in the cache, then we should be able to partition that into smaller blocks. And we should be able to orchestrate our matrix-matrix multiply as a loop over all of these triples of blocks, one from each of the matrices. All right, so then we get something like a loop IJP, a loop ordering that's IJP, or whatever ordering you pick, where then in the middle you call this routine right here, which Mark, for example, might have been the routine that you wrote gem ji 12 by 4 kernel. So you have a loop over I, a loop over J, a loop over P, and then inside of that you call gem ji 12 by 4 kernel.